guys, I'm Anushka Malao, your urban yogi knee. Last night, I went for this really bad corporate party, this office party of mine. Apart from the fact that it was really bad and boring, the food was even worse. So I've landed up with a really bad stomach. So I'm going to try and do a little routine. I hope this helps you and I hope it helps me too. Let's try. So try and keep your feet 1 foot apart, a little parallel to each other, toes facing forward. Yeah. Hands on your hips. Take a deep breath in and exhale out. So all these poses and all these exercises are aimed towards sort of massaging your digestive system. So that sort of, it works super fast and we get well better. So once more, take a deep breath in. As you exhale, drop your hips forward and down. Stay there. Now, from here, drop your hands. Now, you might sort of, you can watch from this side. So my hips might be going away from my ankles. So to avoid that, walk your hands in front. Try and get your hips right above your ankles. Stay there. Really let go. Let go of your hands. Try and hold your elbows if you can. Drop your head. Stay there. Now if you think this is really, really sort of painful or you're not flexible enough, bend your knees. No problem. Stay there. Rest your chest on your thighs. Stay there. Hold your elbows. Drop your knees. From there. Hands out. Hands behind your knees. Hold them. Stay there. Really hug yourself. After a few breaths, hands down, coming up. If you can straighten, stay there. And down. Stay there. Keep breathing. Bend your knees to come up. Drop your hips down. Slowly roll up. And come up. Once more. This time, we're going to try this with our feet apart, yeah? From here. You can have your toes 45 degrees facing. So, hands on your hips, take a deep breath in. Push your hips out, out. Go down further, stay there. Hands on your hips as much as possible. Like the previous time, make sure your hips are not going behind, they're not going away from your ankles, hips going forward. So try and get your weight in front, from here. Stay there once you're here. Now, in case you don't reach the floor, which is absolutely normal, now take a brick, take a pillow, take a stack of books, take whatever you want and just stay there. Relax for a bit. From here, we're going to gently shift our hips, keeping our knees straight, shift it to my right. Stay there. Swap sides to my left. Stay there. Once more. Right. I want you to bend your right knee and just stretch it out. Come back. Bend your left. Come back. Just really mobilizing your lower body. From here, get your feet a little in. And try and sit down. Sit up as much as possible. Have your torso up. If you can, push your elbows out. Push your knees out of the way. Use your elbows to push your knees out. Stay there. From there, let's just go back and forth a little bit. One and out. Two and out. Three and out. Now, over here, if you think this is very uncomfortable, you can have sort of a pillow or, like I said, a stack of books under your bum, behind. If you think you can't put your heels down, which is also very normal, come up. A little bit, yeah? Stay there for as long as you can with your heels up. Stay there. Relax.
Drop your body. Drop your head. Come back.
Stay there. Come up all the way. Use the floor to push away. Up. Once more. Get your feet a little closer. Stay there. Down, down, down. All the way. Take a few breaths. Keep breathing. Bend your knees and gently roll up. Head coming up last. Okay, from here. Extend your feet out. Now, in such a way that my right leg is turned out. Yeah? Over here. Now, make sure your heel is in line with the arch of your foot. Yeah? So try and do it like on a tile or even on your mat. If you can find some design or some mark or something, try and put it in line with each other. Yeah? From here. Squeeze your bum. That's going to keep you stable, because if you think you're a little wobbly, one, you can use the wall. You can have your heel touching the wall behind and your back also touching the wall. That is okay. So you can do the pose touching the wall all throughout. Or you can do this in the middle, whatever you feel like. From here, take a deep breath in. And exhaling out. First, extend to the extended side. Out. From there, drop that hand, look up. See that? Now, if you think you can't go all the way down, use something. Sometimes I use like a little bottle also. It doesn't matter. Yeah? Till the time it's got like a nice big round base, doesn't matter. From here, look up. And hand going up. Stay there. If you can, hold your toe. Stay there. Come back down, bend your knee first, and then come up. Yeah, don't try and come up with straight legs. You might sort of pull something. Let's swap sides. So, get the right foot in, left foot out. All right, making sure my right toes are facing you, and my left heel is in line with my right arch. From there, hands by my side. Take a deep breath in. Extending to the side first. See that? Get used to this sort of displaced upper body position. From there, collapse down, down, down. Stay there. Right. It's not necessary to touch your toes like I did on the other side. If you can, hold them, That's all right. If you can hold them, you can. If you don't want to, it's okay. Stay there. Come back down. Bend your knee to come up slowly and come back. Yeah? Let's try another version. From here. Same thing. Right leg turning out. Left leg towards you. Make sure your right heel is in line with your left arch. Same thing, hands going out. Stay there. Extend towards that leg that's turned out. Stay there. From there, we're going to go down and twist. Now, from here, we're going to keep both our hands next to our right leg. Stay there. From there, try and extend your back. Stay there. Now, from here, we're going to take our left hand, place it over our right foot, and open our hand. Stay there. Coming back. Now, if you think you can't do something like this, it's okay. Keep your left hand in front of your foot and just twist. If you think you can't do this also, no problem. Just stay here. Extend your back. Come back to this position. Stay here. We're really twisting the abdomen here. Come back. Bend your knee first. And slowly come back. Other side. Let's go. Foot going in. Left foot out. Stay there. Out.
Arms by your side.
Going towards the rotated leg. Stay there. From here, drop to the rotation side. Now, from here, we're going to have both our hands next to our left leg this time. From here, we're going to try and extend the back. Really lengthen with the neck. Now, from here, right hand over your left leg and open up. Now, if you think you can't do this, no problem. Keep your hand on the outside of the leg and twist. Also, if you think you can't do this either, no problem. Stay here with both your hands next to your left leg. Stay there. Extend your back. Keep breathing, keep breathing, keep breathing. Come back, bend your knee, and stand up. Right. Yet another variation. From here. Right leg going out. From here. Well, you might want to increase the gap this time. From here. Right leg bending. Now from here, use your right forearm, rest it on your thigh to begin with. Left hand going up, all the way. Keep looking at your left hand, drop your hip. Stay there. Come back. Once more. Other side, twisting. Bend the knee. And
Once more. Coming back. Let's try this again with a little more variation. All right. Right leg, bending. Right side, down. From here, take your right hand, push it behind your right foot. Now, from here, extend the hand and look up. Come back. Extend, slowly come up. One last time. Other side. Bend the knee. First, go down. The simple stuff. From here, if you can, drop your left hand behind your left foot. Keep looking at your right hand. Come back. Use your hands to slowly come up and get your feet in. Right. From here, hands on your hips once more, extending up and pushing your hips back. Let's go. Stay there for a bit. Few deep breaths. Get your weight forward. Make sure it's not falling back. From there, bend your knees and sit down. Whichever direction you want. Toes together, heels apart. Sit up. Stay there. Stay there for a while. This pose is really, really good for your digestive system. On a regular basis, you should be sitting after food for about a few minutes, 3, 4, 5, however you like. Stay there. Keep breathing, take a deep breath in. Once more, if you have a knee injury, don't do this pose, skip to the next one. If you think you can't sit on your heels, put a pillow under your hips. Now, from here, stay there for a bit. Just a few deep breaths. And now, make a fist. Now, with your thumb inside, fingers overlapping each other. Thumb inside, fingers overlapping each other. Now, this area, which has the maximum surface area, you will put it in just above your hip bones, yeah? Really squeeze it in into your lower tummy. From here, take a deep breath in. And exhale out. Going down.
Head down. Stay there. Once more, come back up.
Now this is really, really good for diabetic patients. If you are struggling with high blood sugar, this really accentuates your insulin production. So once more, thumb in, fingers overlapping. Really squeeze it in. And take a deep breath in. Exhaling out. Going down,
going down, going down. Try and keep your hips on your heels as much as possible.
Come back up. And release. In these two positions, you can stay for however long you want, till the time your knees don't give way and, you know, your ankles don't start hurting. From here, we're going to come up. Now, if you're doing this on your bed, it's fine. If you're doing this on your mat, try and fold it in. Take one fold in. So there's a little padding under your knees. From here, lift up, stand up. Squeeze your bum, stay there. Make sure your knees are still under your hips, they're not too wide. Really inside, relax your toes. Keep breathing. Take your palm, put it on the lower back. Other side also. Stay there. Now, take a deep breath in. Completely exhale out. When you're ready, take a deep breath in and push your bum forward and drop your back. Come back when you've had enough. Now, if you think you can't put your entire palm here, no problem. Put it palm facing down. Let's try once more. Exhale out completely. And inhaling once more. Deep breath in. From here, we're going to have our hand going up, back, holding our right ankle, left hand going up, really twisting, looking down first, really thrusting your hip forward, still looking up this time, coming back. And center. Let's repeat it on the other side. Hand going back. And up. Looking down first. Then looking up. Really make sure that your hip doesn't fall through. Push it forward as much as possible. Looking up, come back, and down. One last thing, we're going to try with both our hands. Up, slowly, going back. Now, hold your ankles and thrust your hips. Come back up, slowly, one at a time, and relax. Hopefully, this should really massage your digestive system and get it going in some super fast speed. I hope you feel better tomorrow. Thank you so much for watching.